Good evening, everybody. Today this is welcome to the Hackerspace. Okay, for some of you who might be here for the first time, this is basically a club for geeks. And by day, there's actually a lot of tables and more tables around, and people use it as a space to just work on their startups, on do coding. You also have a tiny hardware room at the back. Okay, and various groups they meet here. There's technical groups that meet here, or there's also groups, a musical group that meets here, a ukulele group. There's also a group that does fermentation that meets here. So this evening we actually have Rex from Shanghai, based in Shanghai, to actually come to Singapore and then share his story about how he actually built this skateboard, and also talk about his other projects. And I understand that Rex is actually based in the Shanghai Hackerspace in Xinjiang. So yeah, a round of applause for Rex, please. Thank you.
From the Shanghai Hackerspace, named Xinjiang, means new factory. Because the Xinjiang before is a very old factory and nobody used that. So some hackers just come in and make it like a hackerspace. Yeah. So that's just the name. And I also before last year I'm a programmer. I learning the programming at 9 years old, I think very young, because my father is an electrical engineer, and I'm very interested in the electric stuff, but he didn't teach me. And he said, you don't need to learn the electric, because when you are 30, I'm 60, and I'm still better than you. So you should be learning something, I don't know. Yes. So he said, because in the 1989, the program is a very new stuff. And my father, he's an electrical engineer. He don't know how to program, and even he very good at electric. So he said, I don't teach you electric stuff, and I just let you learn how to program. And learn something I can do. And so I just he pushed me to learn the program. And so I worked for the VR software many of years, and I quit my school at 17. So I'm not with the college. So I'm worked many years with the VR, and after I tried to write some software named Mentas. It's a tool for the beginner using the Arduino. And the first part I will show it later. And another part is at part time I'm making the electric skateboard at the Hackerspace just for fun because I'm a skater. But after I just raising some money from the VC, and because China has many of young people this startup company, because we can't buy a house, because in Shanghai, a 30-year old house, maybe 15K Singapore dollar per meter. Yeah, it's but you know how many people. How many money in Shanghai you can get? It's just half of Singapore. Yeah, so if you work for a company, you maybe 20 years you only can buy a toilet. Yeah. So you can
you go to a bank?
No.
Okay.
And so you can't lab. So you have to start up your company. If you not start up, you never buy a house. But in China, you must be buy a house to get a girl. And so, yeah, so that's a problem. So I like the other people, I start my company. So I try to make the electric skateboard out of the Hackerspace. And so, because in Hackerspace, some people could just say, oh, Rex, your skateboard cool, can I pre-order one? And you can make it by hand to give it. But after I write some money, I write almost $1 million. Okay. But the timing is perfect because at that time the Chinese VC trust they have some smart hardware and the IoT stuff, and so they trust the people can be IoT stuff now. So after that, I just use that money to keep developing the keyboard, make it sexy, and I go to the Kickstarter and to get a huge money, almost like $700K US dollar. Yeah. So then I have the angel money and the Kickstarter money. I'm making something to to die. So I hire a lot of people and get a big office, give them a free lunch, the perfect coffee machine. So it wasted a lot of money. Yeah, so that was a huge mistake. And even we are in China and we do the manufacturing of the skateboard. We also need to make a problem. Yeah. So if you guys interesting, I can share more story about the how to build stuff, the hardware stuff in China. And let's do something about the manufacturing. And part time I also do some little project like I want to play the ukulele because most people they want to pick up girl, they need to learn some music stuff, and the ukulele is easy than the guitar, so like I want to try it, but only the learning 3 days I don't give up because so tired to learn the left hand, so I try to make a shortcut for it. But I want to just like I'm a child, I play the video game, and it's hard to play the action game. So I just use the.
Sorry, do you have this thing now here now? Because I got two ukuleles here.
No.
Okay, and never mind.
So I just make some body noise, and I use the server to wow. push the ukulele and make a prototype for it. But it's working very well. So at this image you can see I can use a ray to record the different figure. Yeah, so make it easy. Yeah, so I even met the HackerSpace friends who put on that. I get some money from them. Just one of the part-time. But also I'm making some like race car or something in Shenzhen. Shenzhen have a lot of people who just making the useful stuff for fun. Let's check out the software I make it before. It's named the ManPlus. Here it is. Because I also make some like a workshop at the weekend to teach the child to make some stuff. But I found a problem because they have a lot of workshop. But any workshop, if you let people use the Arduino, and you cannot learn it at one day. You just can send the code to them and you just copy to the Arduino editor and upload. But you cannot learn anything. We can do the hardware part. So I'm thinking about if I can do some tools for the beginner or for some people like some people who just make the mechanical stuff, who don't want to learn program, because learn programming is very hard. But normally do the thing is very simple. You just need a very little programming stuff. So I try to make an easy way to let them use. So then, here is it. Let me show you. Here's the Arduino, just a standard Arduino, and I try to put a LED on it. So let's do a very basic stuff. We turn on the LED. So you don't need to program anything. You just need to take some module and the LED.
Oh.
Yeah, and set up the pin you want to give the power.
It's cute.
And here is the star. You should give the module power. Yeah. Here is the like the power generator. And upload it. This can supply all the Arduino board. Yeah. So it's automatically detected Arduino board. Just upload it. Now it's turning on. And if you want to do some logic stuff like the I have a button here. I want to use the button to control the LED, so I also can connect it. Like I connect it to the server. Okay, actually, if you use one button and one LED, you can do many different stuff. Let's try it. button. Actually, you can use another hardware like some any digital sensor. You can use the button mode and change the pin to the thing. Yeah, and here is how it works. When the button is pressed, it's going to be output of power. And you can use the power to turn on the LED. So it works very different with the program. Yeah, because if you write the code for programming, your mind is different thinking like this. Like it's more like the physical stuff. Yeah. So I the button is turned on. But if I want to the button and when the button is released, I can turn off the LED. Yeah, so I can connect it. So upload again. So the function is changed. Yeah, and even if I want to make a light, like I push button once, it's turn on, and I push it again, it's turn off.
Okay.
Yeah, and if you learning the coding, it's a little hard for a beginner. Maybe you need to learn half hour.
Yeah.
But in this, is your thinking is very different. I can show you. Yeah, we have a module like named the switch. Yeah, so it's like the first time it's coming, it's going to be output from the one, the first one. The second is coming, it's going to output from the second one. And again. Or you can use two to make a three switch out, or use four, three to make a four switch out. That can do a different thing. Like when I press the button, I can turn it on. And I press the second time, turn it off. So it's very easy to let people understand. So I press once, it's open, and press
again,
it's on. So, but in the graph, it's very easy to understand.
So is this your company or what you made?
Yes, I work for a hardware company.
They make this one?
No, they make the Arduino.
All right. Okay.
They sell it the Arduino. So they want me build a project. Let people easy to use Arduino.
So this is a commercial product by you?
Yeah.
Wow, that's awesome. This is brilliant.
Yeah. The team only have me and another intern. Yeah.
Oh, wow.
But after the company, they don't want to keep paying money to do that. So I can do it again. So I just make it like open source. Just open source. Yeah. So I make it a skateboard.
So working in WPS.
What?
From
GitHub or from the Dropbox, I think the link.
Yeah, actually yeah, in the event page has a link to GitHub.
And we have the Windows, Mac, and Linux version. So if I still want to share some more functional of this, let me see. If we want to if we want to control the server, and if I want to use the
PWM is it? Or is it a rotary switch? Yeah, it's a rotary potentiometer.
Yes.
Rotary.
I just want to control the servo, and
let
me show you how to do that.
This one?
Yeah.
This is actually a servo motor.
Oh, okay. This is not a sensor and a fender.
I
can just connect the server. It's a motor on the 7 and it's a 6. And the sensor on the is 0. So if you write in the code, the first thing is you should get the data from the sensor, and another thing you should give the data to the server. Yeah. So in this software, it's same. You should read the data, and the data from the pin A0, and you should control the server. Right? The server module is getting power, so it has to give the power. And the server work on the pin 6. And here you want to turn in the server angle, but you can just give the data from here. Yeah. So the data will transform to the server. So all the data and the behavior became a virtual server. Arduino is a rebuild because the server is need too much power. Wow. Yeah, so it's power low and rebuild. And now it's working well because I opened the computer power. Yeah, you can use that to control it. Yeah. And if you want to make it like a mechanical hand, you can use that to do that. And if you want to use this sensor to make some like a music player, yeah, we can do it also. I remove the server, only the sensor, and only need two wires. We can make some music. We connect to the ground, and another is any digital pin, like we keep it at 6. So for this one, we give the data to the server, but we can give the data to another stuff.
Right.
We put it on here. And here is a speaker I just borrowed.
Yeah.
And the speaker, any speaker is okay. We can use some module to make speaker make sound. And the pin on the 6. Another number is the frequency you want to make the sound. And the third value is the time, how long you want to make some noise. So let's upload it and see what happens.
That's milliseconds, I hope.
Yeah, it's just a very short sound.
Let's reload.
Substitute with a pair of earphones. But it may not be loud, but we can come closer to here.
I can use the from the little speaker. I don't know if the speaker will be
okay.
Okay. This works, but
there's not enough power. Is that the issue with that previous speaker?
I'm not very sure. It was a new one. I haven't really gotten.
You got
that?
Yeah.
Just be fine. And it's just very a short song, and if we can make some delay after it, we can make some beat. And give it a loop. And in this software, any loop is just take a while. And it has a multi-thread. So even you have different way, and it's going to be running at the same time. So you don't need to care about the time. Because if you want to make the multi-thread on the Arduino, you have to learn a lot of stuff.
Okay.
Yeah. And we can use the sensor data to control anything. Any rare stuff we can control. We can control the timing. So we give the data to the delay, we can change the delay time.
So you just rotate it. Yeah.
You grab a decent.
Is that better?
Yeah, a little. Yeah.
And we can change the
delay.
And even we can delay that, that's why we can change the frequency of the sound.
It looks like in your sort of visual language there, you have these little red constant things, but just now you put one of the flow things into a constant. What does that mean? You had it before onto, or even here where you put it onto the speaker. So what is 400 there if there's data flowing from the rotation sensor? Does 400 have any meaning now?
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Because it is going to be rewrite from the sensor data.
So,
this module is keep reading the sensor data from the zero pin.
Right.
Yeah, it is going to be rewrite without the 400. 400 without meaning.
So the 400 has no meaning at this point.
So it's just a difference.
You could get rid of it, and it would be the same.
So you can change the frequency now.
Right.
And even you can add the different piece on. So if we have two speaker and but we control the same pin. So we can get a two different sound. And one controlled by you and one is a fixed. Maybe that is faster. Magic stuff happening. it only have one sensor control. If you connect like a 4 or 8, you can make a very complicated music. So it's almost here, but it still have many of module in it, but I can't show so all because I am not bring so many hardware here. And we have like something similar to the keyboard, yeah, to make your Arduino control the computer. Maybe you can get a similar, very long keyboard command, like a open the command terminal and format his desktop disk. Yeah, maybe some and make some IR receiver or send some control the air pollution or something. Control the LED screen, control the LED matrix, and LED matrix you can just make some graph on it. Yeah, it's easy for the beginner. And you can make something like a network. You can use the Arduino Wi-Fi shield, yeah, to connect to the internet. And we can some value from the UI of that, and you can get the OBD base from the car. And you know every car has an OBD connector, and you can get the car speed with that, you know.
Dashboard, I guess.
Yeah, because every car on the
has a jack.
Yeah, yeah. Have a cam, it's named the cam connector, and you can get this from the car. And the something special is if you want to make some remote control or translate some data, use Arduino, it's pretty hard. Because if you just want to translate one bit, it's easy. And, but if you want to translate two values, one is temperature, one is speed, and it's pretty hard because you have to know how to package your protocol, yeah, and you have to know how to re-protocol the data. Yeah, it's pretty hard for the beginner. And in this is very different. Let me show you. If you get some data from here, and here is the base, right? You want to translate the data to the another Arduino or translate to use RF module. So yeah, you can use this one. Send a serial number. It's going to be translated your data. And the translate way is very different. We have a parameter and the package. Yeah, like you send the package to other people. You have to write one name, you know. So you can name it like Tom. And another is the value you want to give the package to them. So you just need to give the sensor data to the inside package and package name Tom. So it's done. And in another Arduino, you just need a wait
for serum.
Yeah. And give the package name. So you can get the right value you want. So it's very easy to use. Because in some high-level language, they also have something like JavaScript.
Mm.
Yeah, they have some functional that. But in the C, it's terrible to make the protocol. Here is it. And that's just some little more.
It's not the sound, just the interface recording.
I have one question.
So let's say, for example, I think anybody who does coding, the one of the very important skills to pick up is debugging. So for example, let's say you do a simple LED blinking, and then you put the wrong pin. I mean, you say it's pin 13, but actually it's actually pin maybe 12, for example. So what kind of debugging does one have to, what kind of errors would be thrown, and how does a student, a user, go about debugging when using your software?
Without debugging, only have
the user error
of the report, but they have not finished the debugging function.
Mm. Yeah. So there will be an error? Will there be an error message? What kind of error message? Is it, for example, no error message.
Just okay. Nothing happens.
Yeah. I see.
Okay. Or is it running at the wrong
way? Mm. Okay.
So you have some question of it?
Yeah. For the serial one, right? The one that you did. Is it only Wi-Fi or is there like Bluetooth?
You mean this model? Yeah. If you can use the different module, and even if the module has a serial port, suppose it can be used, no matter it's Bluetooth or IR or Wi-Fi. Because many of the module like RS and Wi-Fi, they also have the serial port version.
Why are some of the arrows blue and some of the arrows red?
The blue is the power. This can make the module work, and the red one is the data.
Oh, okay. And just if you were coordinating two Arduinos, I just noticed that there are actually two incoming blue arrows. I'm just kind of curious what the second one does.
Let me show it. to connect to the two Arduino.
What would be a good example of a configuration where you would get feedback, where you would need both directions? I'm trying to think.
Maybe at home you want to get some data from the pen, or get
take a temperature? No,
someone may need it.
Yeah, certainly.
Because it's very easy for the, because I know many people in the HackerSpace, they have three kind of people. And one is background is software. And you can write any software, but you don't know how to do stuff.
Do hardware.
Yeah. And Arduino for them is easy. And another people is electric background. And they can lay out the board and they can do the very good stuff. And Arduino also not big problem for them. Many people they make the electric, they know the program a little. Yeah. But some people they just make the mechanical, and most people they doing the wind stuff. And this kind of people they never program it before, and actually they don't want to take many time to learn how to program. But they handle it very good. They can do many of stuff, but it's cool, and they can make the server inside his works. Most times, it just need very easy.
A little bit of programming, yeah.
So, I don't know, for them, even it's very easy, but it's not enough. And this software is very good for the thing. They make the mechanical stuff. If they want to make some remote control stuff or something, it's pretty easy.
How long did you get to do? Yeah, until this stage, get to this stage, this software?
The software, the 1 more year.
You use it, so 1 year it's from now. I mean,
From 2012 to the 2014.
So that's quite a big investment for this.
It looks like it.
It's impressive.
It's a stop, this product. Because I hope somebody can pick it up again.
Did you use like open source stuff from GitHub and
so all the source code is on GitHub.
No, as in, did you program it all yourself or did you use libraries
and
frameworks?
Yeah, do it from scratch or?
Yeah, most of I write it.
Really? Wow.
Because as a company, they don't give much money on this project. This software can now sell money. Yeah, they even can sell Arduino for money, but this one can make money.
Even the engine that does all the graphics, you wrote that? You didn't get it from somewhere?
Yeah. Because I make it, actually, before I make the 3D engine for it, because I make the VR software for it. But the 3D engine is hard to develop because it takes more time. So I use the Qt framework to keep it up.
Qt is that? Qt.
Qt framework.
It's a Nokia.
You know KDE is on Qt? KDE? Qt. Libraries, yeah.
It's based on C++, but it's a Nokia. Nokia company that developed this framework.
And
it can move your C++ project to the different platform. So this software even can run on top of the Pi.
So what's one of the biggest lessons you learned from this project?
For the life?
No, this project. What struck you as something that thought you didn't see that and then oh wow.
Because when I want to close that project because when I'm young, because I'm learning the program very young, and when I'm a child, I go to the Walmart or the supermarket. I saw the software in the box and on the
right.
Yeah, and the people can buy some software like a player, a video player, or some shadow agent.
My Chinese is really bad.
Like a firewall software.
Okay.
Yeah, they can buy this kind of software on the box.
Yeah, yeah.
And the software will make money, and it looks like a copy money. Yeah, software is amazing. Yeah, but when I grew up, the software cannot make money anymore. Because in China, any kind of software is free. Even the Chinese have the office and the WPS is free. And the download software is free. And I don't know, many of software is free. Even the OS, computer OS is free now.
I think that's just largely the world, isn't it? Software is, you know, it's not.
If you can tie software to hardware though, you can then have a product.
Because when I do this project, I'm not stepping the hardware. But I'm still a programmer, so I'm very disappointed at the software. And even I go to the hometown, I cannot tell my mom what I'm doing. Yeah, he asked me why you live home to the Shanghai and what are you doing here. I said I'm making the VR software. What VR? So it's a very understand to know what I'm doing.
Yeah.
So so after I developed this software, I still cannot use that to make money. And the company, they don't want to
support
it anymore. Yeah. Mm-hmm. So I'm very disappointed. So I want to do some stuff in the package and can sell them to make money. And I want to build something like this. So this company, most of my job is develop this software, but sometimes I just develop the hardware, like this Arduino, like the Tiny Arduino. And it turned out.
Wow, tiny.
And I just learn many of things with the electric hardware manufacturing stuff, because and after I want to make some electric funny stuff and to make money. So I just closed that project and quit the job and look for some opportunity to the Shenzhen.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. But I'm taking like half year to look for that opportunity.
So this you mean this project is the one that led you into hardware?
Yeah.
So all right, okay.
Yeah.
So you sort of say I want to figure out hardware and then I'm gonna try this out then.
Yeah.
Oh, cool. So what's the most unexpected, most difficult thing you have learning hardware? Because I as well want to learn, but I haven't sort of gotten the...
Learn to make the DIY stuff or learn to make a company?
No, hardware, as in programming hardware and figuring out what it needs.
Which level you want to get?
I don't know, just making some cool stuff. I haven't sort of figured out what project I want to do, but it's definitely quite interesting to program, to control a piece of hardware.
No need to take too much time, because if you just learning Arduino, maybe 1 month you can do many of stuff.
Right.
Arduino is pretty easy for the program.
So did you see obstacles like maybe electricity that, you know, you sort of, oh wow, I didn't expect this to be so difficult more than it was before? Was it sort of smooth flowing all the way?
I think Arduino is a very...
It's very straightforward.
Yeah, yeah. Because many of people, they work for the community. Yeah. So many people, they write the library for the other people.
Right.
So so if you want to do something, maybe on the GitHub, you already have some people done it before. You can get it and use it.
How about soldering? You do any of those soldering or... I don't figure out...
You mean the hardware?
Electricity or... But you said your father is an electrician, so that's...
Sometimes you can just learn one part of it and send other people together.
Right.
And you don't need to learn programming, showing the mechanical stuff. Yeah. Mm. Even, I think in Hackerspace, sometimes you don't need to learn anything. Even you just have ideas, it's good.
No, it's good. I just sort of think, I guess, for example, I know some programmers, they, you know, program nicely and then they get hit by a wall, and the wall is that the product doesn't look good. It's just really complicated. It doesn't look good. They didn't draw it out, they didn't sketch it all out, and it came up as a sort of, in a way, flop. So that's something that they didn't see in that, if you say hindsight.
This looks pretty good to me.
No, I'm not saying that. I'm saying if I want to get into hardware, is there certain sort of things that you sort of say, oh, right, I didn't expect that, and that's something I thought I could.
Because I think what I would try to do with this is, like, sort of teach yourself Arduino, you know, make a little kit where you could just learn how to put all these things together. Make it like kind of a toy for kids where they could just, I mean... Wouldn't that be possible with this? Would it be very hard?
Because we're using the Arduino just same time. Yeah.
Yeah. So you throw a few Arduinos and a bunch of sensors and effectors into a box, and you know, put some instructions in, and they get the software off of GitHub, and I don't know. It's just the thought.
I mean, it definitely looks fun, but I'm sure as this thing goes, there's. You know, there's several walls that you're gonna hit before you sort of wrap your mind around what it is. And my experience with learning to program is that, you know, there are certain walls that you couldn't see, and then you sort of say, if someone told you, look at that specific thing first, and then you sort of in that way.
Because programming is a real hard work. Because I know many of students been learning the computer science or something, yeah, and it takes 4 years, and. I don't know, in Singapore maybe better, and in China, many of people, they just finished the 4 year from the college, and half of them cannot write a whole software. Even they never write a whole software before. Then we can make the...
simple program.
Yeah. So programming real hard stuff.
Yeah, no, I came to programming very late, at the age of 30 and 35. I do get it, but I definitely want to learn the hardware. I just sort of didn't have time to sort of go into it.
That's
what
I think. If you use a part time to watch the instructable,
instructables.
Yeah. It's a website.
You can
get many of tutorial on it. Right?
Sure.
If you keep doing that, maybe every weekend you doing like half day. I think half year. Later,
you persist.
Question?
No question.
You for the skateboard?
Yeah.
There is a skateboard. You can see the battery, and you can see the motor. It's totally different with the. Skateboard in the market.
Mm.
Because when you want to do that, we just
so yeah. One of our members have one. So just to compare, just, you know.
Yeah. Oh, yes, it's e-skateboard in market.
Yeah. So you can do a comparison. I think, you know, it'll be more interesting.
So this, they're both.
No, this is from someone. I mean, one of our Hackerspace members.
Right, but it's a controllable skateboard.
I'm not very sure. I
is
think
that,
so.
Is that a commercial product? Is that both, or is that made?
Yeah, both are commercial products.
I think it's a commercial product.
Yes, green one is a maybe both is a single scale, right?
Yeah.
Instructable.
Yeah. This one is almost like a snowboard.
Yeah.
It's a freeboard based snowboard.
Yeah, but it's very heavy. I just leave it here. Or it's that yours looks very light.
Yeah. And because before we do that, we make some mistake like the Chinese. Yeah, we just look for the best in the market and copy that. So after 3 months, we do it very well. Because we just buy the best keyboard on the market and send it to the Shenzhen and give the money. And within 1 week, we get all the scratch of the electric design. Because in Shenzhen have very very good ecosystem with on
manufacturing.
It's on re-engineer. Yeah, re-engineer. Yeah. You just give the product to them and pay the money, and within 1 week, they will give you all the data from this project. We have very good rich engineering team in the Shenzhen. A lot of companies make that for money.
So is it re-engineering, as you buy the skateboard and ask them to modify to your requirement. Is that what you're saying?
Because if I want to copy that thing,
yeah.
I just need to take it to Shenzhen and give it to the re-engineer company.
Okay.
Reverse engineering.
And I can get the CAD file of the hardware design, and get the electric scratch design.
Yeah.
And even get the code department to just pay money.
Okay.
Yeah. And not too much.
Okay.
Because we just re-engineer many stuff.
Can you demo that and write that around? Or?
Yeah, of course. Let me.
All right. Yeah. Sorry.
So after 3 months, we just copy a perfect one. But I feel very angry because I hired people. They are very old. They have very much of the experience of the develop, even in the electric, the mechanical, the software I do it by myself. We all the best people, and we do copy stuff. What I'm hungry for is we take like 10,000 or 30,000 hours for our skill. Like, even the mechanical people, they do the mechanical job in like 10 years, and they have many of hours for their skill. We don't respect our skill. Because we take many of hours to do that. But we just do a hobby stuff. Hobby stuff don't need us. Hobby stuff, the student can do that, the Shenzhen company can do that. We don't need to do that. Yeah, so we just break the hobby stuff. And we are thinking about, and we are very rich at that time. Because we invest a lot of money. I'm thinking about, and 1 year we don't need to get any money, and we can pay them, no problem. So we want to do something real different, like the market. And so we just think about it. We want to no battery, we want to no motor, because a lot of skateboard market is the motor in here and the wheel in here. Yeah, so we want to do that very different. So we think about, can we put the motor inside the board, maybe on the board, maybe on the wheel, maybe on the truck, maybe somewhere, but we cannot see that. And we think about, can we put the battery like a MacBook Air? Because when MacBook Air released, every computer battery it would be happy.
Yeah.
Every computer. And but Apple, they make the battery remote. Yeah, and we think about MacBook can make it so light, and we can do that also. Yeah, we can copy that idea to the skateboard. Yeah, so we try to change the material and talk to the factory. But the factory is they don't care about us, because we go to that factory and the factory said, how many want to do? I said, one. for the prototype. And he said, get out of my office.
Oh,
you waste my time. So we try to visit every factory to making the skateboard in China. I mean, at the mountain, the country, and the very
village.
Yeah.
And we find a skill. We just waiting for the door watcher, and then we give the security to the door watcher. Yeah, the security. Yeah, and we ask them, what time you finishing job last week or last month? And if they say, there have no busy here. Yeah, we finish job at the right time, and yes, good factory, because we don't have work to do, and you can let them to work for you. Yeah, if they said, I just finished my job at 10 or 11, and we are very busy, and you just go away, because you cannot see the boss. Yeah, they are too busy, and they have a lot of money to come in, so they don't need it. Yeah, so we find the factory to help us to improve the material. Because it's a very
thin.
Yeah, but it can handle three people stand on it. Yeah, so the material, and it's very long, so the material must be very strong. And it's limited inside, so the material must be very strong. So we developed a manual version. Yeah, so we put the battery inside, so you cannot see that, and all the controls inside here. And plus it's making hot, so it's need metal to for it.
Right.
And here is the motor inside
the
but,
wheel.
Yeah, but we found a problem, because inside the wheel make the hub motor, it's called.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, but hub motor have a very weak point in the size. Yeah, if your size is very huge, you can have many of the
magnets.
Yeah, so it's very powerful. But if you very less, you may have very little of the magnets, so it's not power enough. So you just make a gearbox inside, so it's running at a different
like a planetary gear. Is that how?
Yeah.
Right.
Yeah. So it's a same. Because normal gearbox still need space. So we only can do a pair.
Wow.
Yeah, it's inside. So it's make the motor have three times torque.
Torque.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So this skateboard can go 30 kilometers per hour.
Wow.
Real fast. And it can take any people uphill the underground parking, no problem.
Huh?
Yeah. So on the floor, three people only, no problem. Very, very powerful. And here is the remote. They have the OLED screen, because the OLED is very saving power.
Mm-hmm.
And this remote can work like a dummy, and you need to free charge. Yeah. And it has the magnet sensor inside, so you can put the remote on it. So you push forward to go, and that will break. And when you break, it's going to be power regenerate back to the battery. Mm-hmm. Yeah, there is.
Yeah, so the regenerator is a very nice idea.
Because we built it very thin, and the range is not enough like this one.
Yeah.
So we have to let people go longer.
So how long?
We need that for.
Depends on how much you regenerate.
15 kilometers.
So did you? Did you do a lot of tests on the batteries, because that's like the infamous problem, isn't it?
Of course.
And moreover, that's like the load is, you're going to have lots of.
We know that. Because many of our board they got a problem with that. So we try the many time to figure out what's happened to them. And we found the battery did not explosion. Yeah, because it's not the bomb. Yeah, because the battery, if it's explosion, it only have one reason. Because it's have too many voltage inside. Yeah, and even you break the when you cut the skateboard, you cut the battery, it's not fire on the screen.
Okay.
It only can explode or make fire with the overcharge. That's the only reason. Because you can take your phone or something, you cut it, oven, it's gonna be exploding.
No?
So what if I took this to the top of a big hill, started heading down, threw it into regenerative mode, could I blow it up if I just...
If you're real fast and you're not ready for it, you're gonna blow up. Yeah, so people play skateboard need to control by yourself. But that's the reason making it cool.
Small startups cannot be using the specialized battery. If you need a US only battery cell, need more than millions of lot number with battery company, you have to choose maybe battery cell on the market.
Customized batteries are real hard to talk to.
So did you learn the battery by yourself, or was that process, or did you take lots of tests then?
Because at first we found the battery factory in all around the China. Most people just use it's just a Tesla battery because it's a standard product. And if you want to make the customized battery, it's very hard. You have to find the different battery factory. But the battery factory only makes the battery. You don't make the package. Then you need to find another factory to do the package.
All right, really.
Because they don't sell the battery factory. They just sell the battery cell. Battery cell is just the material with the package. But the package cannot connect to another thing. So you have to another company to do the high voltage shielding to make the battery together.
Did you have to take a class on how this works, or did you found it out, or you have this knowledge before?
No, there was no class for it.
So you have to sort of poke around and test and see what's going on?
Just drink tea. Because in China, we do business with
drink
tea.
Right.
Yeah.
Mao Tai? No Mao Tai?
No, we just drink tea.
Just tea?
Yeah, you have to drink like 100 cup in a day. Yeah. Because you can go to even you can go to this wheel company, wheel factory, and you can go to the wheel factory and drink to the boss, and you drink and you say, oh, I'm very worried about how to make the battery, and maybe they don't know the battery factory, but they know, I got a customer, they making some powerboard or something like, they buy my wheel, and they use battery too, maybe you can talk to them.
So they let you into the factory to see their process of how they make.
No, you can't see.
Oh, you can't see that. So you have to sort of learn
that
way. Right. Okay.
Yeah.
But you have to trust that they make it to your spec or.
Yeah, by 50.
Right.
Yeah. He can trust you.
Yeah, I also agree with Cam. Between big company to big company, they need a lot of drinks and maybe the process. But a small startup between the small factory in China is more easy to only the tea, because small organization and small organization, and they have to decide on themselves. More and more logical process.
But so you picked up the knowledge through just reading the internet.
If you know nothing with the battery,
right?
You drink to the wheel factory boss. And he said, okay, you can find another company. They maybe know that. And they will give you address or number. And you try to another company and see what are you doing. And he will say, oh, child, you are so full. And you know nothing with it. And you just said, please tell me. Please tell me more about it.
So you went through several iterations, like testing to blow it up, to sort of throw it, and then if it catches on fire.
Yeah, if you give the respect for the factory boss,
right.
And he will think, oh, young people do, and he'll tell you something.
I think there was one in New York that were doing electric skateboard and it was selling quite a bit on Kickstarter or something like that. And then one of the boards blew up, caught on fire, and the whole business went down the drain. Yeah. I think that one, if I remember correctly, that was a quite famous example.
You mean it's a fail or?
Yeah. I think that they had to recall all the boards because one of them
blew up.
I think it's. I'm not sure what the company is, but it's just.
Because the reason of the hoverboard, most of the blood is a hoverboard, and the Note 7 is another problem. But most of the hoverboard blood, the reason is like, hoverboard is very cheap. It's very, very cheap. Only one, like a 5-member?
In Shenzhen, it's 399 RMB.
Yeah. In Shenzhen, it's almost like 18 Singapore dollar. Yeah, you can buy a hoverboard.
Yes.
That's super cheap. And but you cannot make the hoverboard cheap like this. Yeah, so kind of the battery have this part. That's a seal. And that's the package. And on the package have something named protected
battery controller.
Yeah, microcontroller to protect the battery. And then
just do away with that.
And this controller is very, very expensive because they have a gate to open the power. The gate named the MOS. Yeah, and MOS is a pretty expensive stuff in the electric. And the hoverboard, this type of thing, it's power more than the phone, so it needs a very big gate, and the gate named MOS is more expensive. So like this board, maybe they need $10 or $10 to protect it. Yeah, but if you sell a whole board only $90, you cannot pay $10 to take the battery. So some factory, they just said, okay, I remove it. Yeah. But the distributor it always asks the cheaper stuff. So the factory said, okay, if I remove it, it's going to be very dangerous. And the distributor said, it's no problem. Yeah, and we just need the cheap stuff. That's it, they just remove. And if you remove, when you charge the board, the voltage cannot control. Yeah. So sometimes it just overcharge. And if you charge it, keep it charged like a week, it's gonna be over.
What do you think about putting off-road wheels?
Okay.
Off-road wheels, so bigger with air.
For like dirt, like instead of going over a flat surface, going over something very rough. So you need bigger wheels.
No, but this is a longboard, and the longboard is a sport. Mm-hmm. And the longboard sport have their own
specification.
Yeah. So if you make a nerd stuff, if you will not say that.
It'd be quite cool, I think, if you could sort of snap on an off-road air.
But the longboard girl, they don't think it's cool.
Well, you to be the first, isn't it? The first is always.
It's useful, but for the girls, you don't think that.
Yeah, that's a much better transportation product, but not a skateboard.
Yeah. So you should you should respect the normal skateboarder. Yeah.
Okay. So how many factories do you need to make one?
We have 140 parts, and in bulk, and. We have like 12 factories, some factory like the wheel, the metal is a factory, the wind is a factory, all the metal is a factory, the beer is a factory, probably a lot of beer inside, and the deer and the metal is a different, the deer needs a special machine to do that, and even you have to buy some nice for the only you can do that. You don't want to do the freehand nice to do that.
Oh, the static gear is a specific, you mean?
Yeah.
Wow.
Because if you just use the... Because gear has a many of way to do.
Yeah.
Some way, very cheap, is just use we name the electric spark.
Yeah.
It's just use a very a light, metal light, and to cut the metal.
Yeah, but specific VR is so expensive.
No, it's very cheap. Very cheap. Because sometimes they don't use the first hand light. The second hand from the Tokyo or from Korea.
Oh, yes.
Yeah, so it's cheap. But the problem is the surface is very bad. So the gear will not work.
Yes.
If it's too small, make the big gear no problem. Yeah. And if you want to make some smooth surface, you have to use knife to cut it.
Mm.
And the knife is very expensive.
Mm.
And actually they only use like a second hand or three hand knife to do that thing. But our gear is very small, so it's cannot use a second hand knife to cut it. So you have to buy a knife for them.
Yeah.
And after the gear cuts, because if your metal is very hard, you cannot cut. So you only have only can use the source metal, I think. I don't know the name. It's without fire. It's soft.
Right. I'm tempered.
Because metal,
it's not heated up.
Yeah. So you do that after you shape it?
Yes. Because we cut first and put it on the yeah. So use fire to output control that. But they have not a problem inside because they have a very big room to make it hot. And the raw parts is only low. Yeah. So they cannot put your part at the best position. Maybe at the corner. But the corner temperature is different with. Yeah, and they cannot set up the temperature curve for you yourself. Yeah, so maybe if you have thousands of gear, but only half parts is okay. Half parts is too hot or too cold. Yeah, so but they don't care. They give you thousands of gear, you have to pay. And then you have to get a lot of nothing to use here. So the manufacturer is very, very deep.
So how about maintenance? Like, do you need to like grease bearings or wear and tear? Maintenance, if let's say a part breaks.
You know what a bearing is?
Yeah.
So bearings need grease, right?
Yeah.
And they wear out, is what he's asking.
So let's say, I don't know, the one wheel is weird. It's not
the oil is dry.
Right. The oil is dry or something that needs maintenance is there like did you sort of factor it in the maintenance of the board or
it's just like bicycle, you only can find some workshops.
Ah right, okay. Yeah. So you need to go to the workshop too, okay.
Because it's only just dry.
If you were able to make that into a product, how much do you think you would sell it for? Well,
I think it's productized.
It is in production.
Yeah, it's in production, right?
Yeah.
So, how many? What does it cost?
Yeah, Kickstarter. Because
selling hardware is pretty terrible.
Mm-hmm.
Before I can work, I can make like I'm 7 years. I can get. 4,000 Singapore dollars per month, but in China it's a huge money because everything is cheaper. But buy a house is still enough money. And for me, I think maybe 4,000 per month is okay. I can buy something I want. But after I do the hardware, it's a very large number. And let's make a prompt. If we can build a 15 more per day.
Okay.
Whole factory. We have a lot of people and every people work harder. Yeah, 50. We have a lot of people and a lot of people work harder. We making 50 per day. It's a very little number.
Uh-huh.
If you have a factory and you have a whole year,
uh-huh.
And you can make like a.
Okay.
Yeah, it is just this number of stable. It's not too much per year. Yeah, it's a whole factory. And if every board sell like a
99
US dollar, you can make that US dollar.
Okay.
Yeah, it's a very, very, very huge money.
Is there that many skateboarders?
Yeah, because making the sale hardware is a real big money.
Right.
It's not like the software.
Right.
Yeah, because before. Before I'm doing that, I never have a lot of money, like 5 million in my pocket. But after this, we have sometimes we really need money. Yeah, because when we making the whole board, it costs a lot of good money.
Where do you see a market? Do you see in America, which I guess that's like particularly California, I guess that would be. The West Coast, that would be.
Yeah, and
China.
Borrow money from the bank. And I think, okay, 1 million, that's fine, no problem. And I send them with my personal. Yeah. So if you do the hardware, you have a very healthy part.
Which company most backed the Kickstarter in that story? You know the which country is the most backers country?
Kickstarter campaign. Do you have the information about which countries
is
most popular amongst the backers?
US.
Yeah.
US type product.
So how many orders have you gotten on Kickstarter for this?
Order?
Oh yeah,
1,400.
Does that cover your costs? If you make 1,500, will you break even?
Sounds like a big money, but it's not enough. Because you have to buy the material first.
Uh-huh.
And before we do that, especially the maker. The maker normally think we don't need too much money. Like we want to build something to go wrong. And the one is cheap, so we don't need too much money. So if your stuff is the cost is 100, you think maybe 120 is okay.
Yeah.
And some folks just tell you should have like a 2.3.
Yeah.
So
well, after crowdfunding is a communication or relationship, not a profit on funding.
Yeah, so you think
2.3x.
Yeah, so you think maybe 200 is a very good money. Yeah, actually it's not. It's totally not. Yeah, because if you have your own website and you sell by yourself, it's okay. It's no problem. You can get 130 from per project or product, but. Your website only have like 100 people visit per day, and you don't have more. If you want more, you have to pay very expensive ad for the Facebook or Twitter.
Sure.
Yeah, very expensive. Some people just click your ad, come in, and you don't buy something. You just watch your website. You need to pay $3, maybe more.
Yeah. Do you think like I would guess this is a very specialized market that you are sort of entering, but I guess the technology would be similar to those more ubiquitous cycles that you see people. So what do you think if you were to sort of, would you say it would be a good idea to sort of use that, your gears and stuff like that? I would imagine that would be great with, you know, with a cool design and then in one of those scooters that...
Actually,
that
we already done.
Oh, really?
Yeah, we're gonna release that summer.
Oh, cool. Yeah. All right.
It's a scooter. Yeah, but only this side.
Oh, okay.
So we're almost already done.
It's similar to this. That's what we can handle.
Yeah. That is super light for this. Just kind of this side, yeah.
No, only forward.
If you go backward, it's just like a bicycle.
Yeah.
The direction is wrong, so it's a danger. You know, just how the electric motor you can run in a different direction. You know, we just use the software, not the internet.
First time you see this, so this is about typo. Impossible to demonstrate what space is so dangerous. So if you have a movie or demonstrate in a scope of a movie shot. Demonstration movie.
You mean the player safety?
No.
Demo video, is it demo video?
Demo video. Oh, yes, you can see the Kickstarter.
Menu.
I want to see a video.
Wait.
You want to see the promotion movie, the skateboard.
Want to see the video?
Yeah, want to see the video.
Oh, some video. This one have a...
There we go.
Most of it's shown by our Kickstarter
background.
Okay.
So it's not showing by us.
But this one is the other one, right? Not too easy.
It's a very expensive CG if it is.
This one is not a computer graphic, right?
This is shown by us. It's a different. This is a Kickstarter video, but the metal is not black.
So you've already delivered to many of your Kickstarter backers, and some of them have contributed videos back to you.
Yeah,
I think some scenes are only the mock-up, but some scenes are real, real prototype.
What, in comparing the weights?
Let's try this.
Do you know there's a company called Evolve?
Yeah, I know.
It's an electric skateboard.
It's a Malaysia company.
So their design is similar to yours?
Yeah.
So what's the difference between yours and their design?
His motor is like this. Because it's have a motor and have a gear and the wheel is the other side. Yeah. And the battery is covered. Before he just make some skateboard like this.
So how much what is the minimum order quantity for the factory to accept your order? How much do you need to order before the factory will accept?
Lots of tea.
Actually the factory don't care about how many orders you can give it once. What you really care about is how long you will die.
How long you will
survive.
Yeah. Survive.
Yeah, yeah.
Because factory, they don't care about how much money they can get. They care about if you can alive, and you can keep giving them money. Mm. Even if they give $1, it's good.
Mm.
Yeah, because they don't want you give it maybe like $1,000 and tomorrow you go. Because factory, if it can make it the best product for you, they have to change the factory.
Okay.
You know that,
yeah.
If you want some special way to do that, they will train the worker. They will change the room of the factory,
yeah.
And do this thing very cost money. And after they change all the stuff, and you die. They do that for nothing.
But they're sort of okay with the idea of like changing the factory, doing your stuff for a while, changing the factory again, doing somebody else's stuff for a while, and then changing it back and doing more for you. That's okay.
Most factories they just like this, because some factories they are very lucky; they can get a big order, so they can do something
continuously,
whole day. But some little factories they don't have enough order; they just can find like a three stuff to do, and they have one problem is you have to wait for the factory. So because if you want to change all the color, and you said okay, can you remove the wheel and change another color on it? He said no problem, we can do that only one day. But before you have to wait 2 weeks, because they have another order and you have to wait for it's finished. But the whole job only one day. So it's a very wasting time. But sometimes your distributor, your dealer, you cannot understand why you have to wait 2 weeks.
So are these factories more open now that they see newer products coming in, newer cooler products? Do they give you more attention? Do they say we want to do more newer products, or do they say, look, we want to just do the old tried and tested thing, we don't care about your new startups, you're not important enough? Are they more open now because they see the potential in all this thing, and then they start to change their ideas?
Sometimes if your order is very little and you not drink too much tea with it, and there are some dangerous stuff will happen. For example, if you have this product, it's very very cool and very useful. And you not drink too much tea with the boss, and then you only need to do like 500 of this. And they said, okay, no problem, we can do that. And you have to watch out. But they do the 500 only can get like a thousand bucks of money.
Mm.
Yeah. And for them it's nothing. But they can know how to do that thing and sell that technology to the other factory.
So they're gonna copy it and
they not copy, they're selling the way of copying. They're selling the copy technology to the other factory, and let the whole factory to do that. And they just said, oh, sorry, we don't have time to do our business, and keep making the copy stuff.
Mm.
Yeah, many of Chinese companies, very good companies, they die like this. Because if you look at that, maybe you have to sell $100, but the copy one only $10.
So you split your stuff up to different factories?
That's the first step, and another step is they have their own factory.
Ah, right, okay.
To the
assembly.
Yeah.
So they don't know how to get it really properly in.
Actually, you cannot let them know each other. Because in China, you only have 6 cup of tea, you can know anyone.
Right.
So the only thing is just
you want Wi-Fi? I give you Wi-Fi.
If you want to make some...
Yeah, the Wi-Fi is a Wi-Fi. You can translate.
No, it's okay. If you want to make some like...
The mold, is it?
Plastic.
The mold, injection mold.
You need the mold. And the mold is very, very expensive.
Yes.
Yeah, it's very expensive. And if you control this, it's hard to copy. But for them, re-engineer your mold is very expensive.
You making the old mold, not Dragon mold.
Even the
what mold is it?
Even some parts like
It's a
special.
Yeah, especially
the
maybe
army
digesting.
Yeah, of parts is customized.
Wow, yeah, that's important. No gomban, no gombo.
Yeah.
But this is a
many
gomban, gombo.
So people they want to do the similar thing.
Yeah.
They will be looking for some gomban. Gomban
gombo
is like
Public custom, public case, and source. Public motherboard.
Oh. Yeah. But then we can send to Shenzhen and then we engineer or something. Yeah, but we have to pay the money to do the
reverse engineering.
No, yeah, like the
more.
Yeah, if the study will become the more millions of products, maybe we can find a COVID study. But maybe 10,000 or 100,000 is not.
Yeah, I mean, if you can sell at 16 million, I mean, the factories will find a way to copy this. So that's. I mean, I guess that's where you build your brand, isn't it? That's where you say, look, Starry is really cool and really safe. The battery is great.
But in China, you cannot get all the fish by yourself because any business you cannot escape. Because Chinese, they very like to do the same visit. If they see you get money, they will.
I think DJI is that's the best example. It's not nobody has yet successfully copied DJI.
DJI is famous in the public, but they're not the biggest company.
No.
No.
But it's like this where you go to buy if you want drones. That's DJI is the first company you go to get drones now. Is that, am I wrong?
But when I go to the far Shanghai, I can very easy to find a copy of DJI.
Really?
But the form is very similar. Function and quality is
exactly. So what I'm saying is that they build up, you know, such strength in that.
DJI is
a very good example for hardware that
yes.
software, you know, the way the drone is being controlled. Mm-hmm. I don't think that's like
Chinese businessman, they don't think about it because if I want to build another DJI or I can copy DJI, it's too expensive because I need to pay a lot of money for the mode I have to have a lot of money to do anything. But most Chinese businessmen, they do the very cheap job, only like 20 Singapore dollar. You can buy a draw and you can fly with
him. So I guess what I'm saying is when you reach a certain market cap, you know, you're getting a lot of products, lots of products, then lots of people will be copying you. So I'm saying DJI, lots of money, everyone wants to copy DJI, but they can't. GoPro tried to do the drone, didn't do it as well as DJI. So I guess what I'm saying is that I guess if there is an example for a perfect hardware company, and a DJI would be one, isn't it?
If you want to listen, I can see that. It's a hard story. Because when you do the business, the most thing you think about is not how cool your product is and not how much money you can get. Mm-hmm. It's about risk. All the things about risk. And if you can survive, you can get money, and you can wait for the opportunity. And some opportunity is filled down your head, you can get a lot of money. So all the Chinese businessmen, they think about is risk. So why they don't make the second DJI or they're making the 100 RMB draw? It's because they don't do the whole draw. So like if I want to do that business, I think it's a very good business. I will send you. You are my friend. You make the plastics business, and I make the motor business, and maybe another people that make some package business, and we can do that business together. And everybody do the one part of it, and it's about we can control the risk. If I die, you die with me. Yeah, so if many people they on the same boat, we can control the market. We can control the material money. Yeah. So the other people they want to do that, the material is they can't buy it, or they can buy the very expensive. And another of our brother, he making the retailer business. He can control all the cable in the market. So another people, if they not the symbol, they cannot put the product on the showcase. They cannot get in. So we can use that way to control the market. And for our personal, we only need to do very similar thing. Just make the plastic stuff. Yeah, but we still can get money from this business. But if you want to make another DJI, you have to fight with all the people. And every day you maybe die. Some plastic material money is higher, you die. And your engineer living, you die. Your sales living, you die. There are too many risks for a hero. So most Chinese businessmen, they just say, not be a hero. And we together to have a big boat. That's why no Chinese company do the DJI. They do the 100 RMB draw. They make more grass money. How to do that?
Sorry, what?
That's the point.
Grass money.
DJI is scaling already. Yeah, scaling is also very important but very difficult for the startup scene.
Yeah, besides, I mean, yeah, I agree, absolutely.
Yeah,
my other point is that besides the scale is that...
What was he trying to say? So the other people, they do a more what version?
They're doing the low version.
A very low version.
Yes. But they can get the same money and they like DJI. Because the money is not about your product selling. It's about if the DJI drone is like 1,000 RMB, and the cost maybe 2,000. Yeah, you can get a 15. Yeah, gross.
Yeah. Right.
But the Chinese 100 drone, they're selling 100 RMB, but the cost is still 15.
50.
Yeah. Yeah. So it's same business, and do that business only. Do your best thing, making the plastic, and you can get the same money. Why you need to be a hero, fight to all the people? But that's the way to think about it. So the Chinese businessmen, they really get a lot of money, because they don't care about the famous. So DJI, maybe the hero, they can stand out, but most of people, they want to be their hero to die.
But yeah, no, I'm saying yeah, it's a great GoPro is trying to do that, to the same thing. There's a parrot, the French one.
That's another point. GoPro is maybe very similar quality than original GoPro. That's in now GoPro is a very very difficult situation.
Yeah.
Now GoPro is very hard.
Yeah, very hard.
Yeah, because the big one is the big one. As I said, the big one is a very low price. But they have very big group. Like they have a very, very good relationship with the material. I mean the
suppliers.
Operator.
DJI can succeed. Still top of the world. Still high end. But GoPro is a very difficult situation. In price is still high, but quality is maybe same as.
As
a
Shanghai
product. Right. It's a very good thing with the Chinese mobile phone.
Yes.
Before 5 years, Apple is a very, very, very
yes.
And the Chinese phone is very low quality.
Yeah.
And now you can see many of Chinese factories, they can get the new technology before Apple. Yeah, because Apple said, okay, I'm a very famous company, I can give you an order like one billion order. But the big group of Chinese, they can say, okay, Apple give me that money, I give you 10. How about this business? And you give me your new technology before Apple get it.
I think mobile phones are more complex, more complicated than that. You involve governments, and you know there are more will to bring an advanced smartphone in. I was just saying if ever the most successful Chinese, you know, hardware manufacturer, both quality, looks cool, marketing, everything DJI, I think, you know, it's one very successful example that sort of, it's also very difficult to copy, size, software, intellectual property. I think all this that sort of build up in that sense that all the other, you know, factories are unable to copy DJI because you need effort, you need the will, and they don't see.
What I'm sharing today, I think it's very different with the American spirit to start a company. Because they're thinking about creating something, innovation something, they try to be a hero, but it will die. It's very easy to die. Yeah, but I'm telling about it's just experience.
Oh yeah, I mean it's brilliant. I mean I think it will definitely do well. I think the one that you said, the little motor scooter, that I think will be a really proper hot seller. That one is, but I guess if you can reach, you know, that certain millions of dollars, they eventually are going to be copying you, and I guess that's good in a way, and then you sort of have a different problem to deal with. In that,
you can't stop the copy because
you can't stop. Sure. Of course, yeah. That's a market.
You share first or you share later.
I have one question before I go. It looks like, okay, you started off, you're not even a mechanical engineer, but you have this idea. And now I look on Kickstarter, it looks like you have 20 or 30 employees, PR, marketing. So how did you build the company up? How did you get all these people to work for you?
Because you are a layer of team. You don't need any skill. Because if you can get a resource, the resource and the human cost is a very, your resource is very huge. The human cost is very less. You can use like a 10,000 Singapore dollar, hire a very, I think it's, you can hire any people. Yeah, like very best people. But it's, as a VC give you money, your fund money, it's very huge. That is, you can hire any people, but you cannot hire risk. Yeah. So why you can control this, like resource or not? Another people. We are both human, right? Because you take all the risk.
Risk.
Yeah.
Well, thank you very much. That was really an excellent presentation.
Yeah.
Very
thanks.
Interesting.
Thank you. I think it's almost done. You have some questions we can discuss.
Thank you.
Very impressive. Very impressive.
Sorry about my English.